Hello, it is Leslie Lois Unfiltered. It's Thursday already. Can you believe we're literally the end of August? And yes, if you've noticed, I did get some more color back in my hair. I actually had a haircut yesterday. Sorry about that. The big hand in the way. I had posted a picture of me yesterday in the cap before, as I was getting my hair done. I threw some purple in there with the blue. I was missing kind of the purple, so it's always fun to do something. I love changing it up, you know, since my hair is stayed kind of short. It's fun to do color with it, so I'm really happy with it. Anyway, I wanted to talk a little bit about traveling with all this pandemic stuff. I know things, thank goodness, look like they're on the upswing. Crossing my fingers that everything goes well during flu season with this pandemic. But how are you about traveling in right now? I know a lot of, so there's some friends of mine here that have, like, haven't even gone to a restaurant yet, let alone travel across the country or anything. But we, my husband and I, were set to go to my hometown back to see my family in Milwaukee. In like little less than 2 weeks, actually, we were supposed to go. Originally, we were supposed to go because my sister was getting married, and I'm the maid of honor, so obviously I would have to go. But she ended up postponing their wedding until next year because the venue couldn't guarantee that they could have it. You know, of course, all the unknown, right? So she postponed it, but she postponed it the day after I had bought our tickets, our air flights to go back to Milwaukee. So we thought, well, you know what? Maybe we can still, let's go anyway. You know, I haven't seen my family since last August. And I, you know, so I always like to try to see them at least once a year. So I thought, okay, we'll just go and, you know. But as things changed and things got worse here, things got worse in Wisconsin, you know, then we started to question it, going, is this the right time to travel? What, you know, back and forth about it. Now, we if we don't go, we still can use the airfare. We have a year to use it from when we purchased it, right? So, I don't know, we both, my husband and I, were feeling kind of uneasy about it. And he said to me, how would you, because we're staying with my parents, that's the other thing, really. And so he was like, how guilty would you feel if we go there and we brought something to them and they got sick because of it? You know, I feel horrible about that, you know. And so there's been a lot of apprehension. We went back and forth a lot on it. And we finally decided, you know what, no, let's hold off until things are a little bit better and we don't feel so uneasy about things. And I was a little hesitant to tell my mom because I know she was happy and excited to see us, but actually she also had some concerns. She had more concerns, I think, about what we could do. There's a lot of stuff still closed, you know, all that kind of stuff. But so it worked out that we both are kind of like, okay, let's just hold off a little bit. And then I was talking to a good friend of mine from Milwaukee. They travel all the time and they have not traveled during this whole pandemic. Well, they flew to Maine this weekend, and she was texting me last night asking me if we were going to go or not. And so I was asking her about her experience. Now, she said the airline that they took was doing all the right things. They did everything right. It's the people that were not doing the right thing. She was telling me about, like, sorry for the shakiness, it's my finger. she was telling me that as soon as, you know, they pulled in to the airport and stuff, and this off seatbelts off went off, people's like forgot about social distancing, and you know how people are on a plane, and they you know, everyone gets up at the same time and tries to get out. So that's exactly what it was. It was a little chaos, and I'm like, people, you know, you're gonna get off the plane, right? You can just, like, don't have to pile on top of each other. So that was one thing she was telling me about. And then she was telling me about this guy in the airport that pulled his mask down, coughed in his hand, and then pulled his mask up with the hand he had coughed on. That's just two examples of things. And she said to me, she goes, they think that, she's like, we're pretty sure we're not going to fly again until there's a vaccine, which I know the airlines are not thrilled of having, but it also made me feel better about my decision about holding off on traveling as much as I want to see my family. I do miss them and stuff, but we're hoping maybe before the end of the year, or if not for sure, we'll go in the spring. So I don't know. What are your thoughts about it? What do you think? I think it's better to be safe than sorry, right? All right, that's my my question and my rant today on Leslie Lois Unfiltered. Thank you for watching, and I'll talk to you again on the next Leslie Lois Unfiltered.